Hi, my name is Emma and I'm the Chief Scientist at Eyes on Science, and today I'll be going over the theory behind Zeta Potential measurements using Tunable Resistive Pulse Sensing, or TRPS for short. I will start with some Zeta Potential basics. The Zeta Potential is a function of the surface charge which develops when any material is placed in a liquid. The Zeta Potential also depends on the type of surrounding liquid or electrolyte, for example, the pH, the ion type, and concentration. For suspended particles in liquid, it is the electrostatic potential at the particle slip plane, as shown here. It is a very good indication of the magnitude of the electrostatic repulsive interaction between particles. The Zeta potential is commonly used to predict and control dispersion stability. The higher the absolute Zeta potential, the more stable the respective dispersion. The development of a net charge at the particle surface affects the distribution of ions in the surrounding interfacial region, resulting in an increased concentration of counterions close to the surface. Thus, an electrical double layer exists around each particle. The liquid layer surrounding the particle exists as two parts: an inner region, called the Stern layer, where the ions are strongly bound, and an outer, diffuse region, where they are less firmly attached. Within the diffuse layer, there is a notional boundary inside where the ions and particles form a stable entity. When a particle moves, ions within the boundary move with it, but any ions beyond the boundary do not travel with the particle. This boundary is called the surface of hydrodynamic shear or slip plane. This is the point at which the Zeta potential is measured, representing how far away from the surface of the particle the electric charge influences the solvent ions by dragging them with it when it moves. A higher Zeta potential, either positive or negative, will pour more counterions in the solvent with the particle as it moves through solution. An important consequence of the existence of electrical charges on the surface of particles is that they will exhibit certain effects under the influence of an applied electric field. These effects are collectively defined as electrokinetic effects. In TRPS, there are two major electrokinetic effects that need to be considered to predict the resulting particle movement through a pore. These are electrophoresis and electroosmosis. Electrophoresis is the movement of a charged particle relative to the liquid it is suspended in under the influence of an applied electric field. Electroosmosis, however, is the movement of a liquid relative to a stationary charged surface under the influence of an electric field. For very small pores, dielectrophoresis may also play a role, but this is not considered for the purpose of this discussion. Now I will talk about electrophoretic mobility in more detail. When an electric field is applied across an electrolyte, charged particles suspended in the electrolyte are attracted towards the electrode of opposite charge. Viscous forces acting on the particles tend to oppose this movement. When equilibrium is reached between these two opposing forces, the particles move with constant velocity. This velocity of the particle is dependent on the following factors: the strength of the electric field or voltage gradient, the dielectric constant of the medium represented by epsilon, the viscosity of the medium represented by eta, and the Zeta potential. The velocity of a particle in an electric field is commonly referred to as its electrophoretic mobility. In a typical Zeta potential measurement, this mobility, represented by mu, is determined, and from that, the Zeta potential calculated via the Henry equation. Current practice for measuring the Zeta potential of particles includes laser Doppler microelectrophoresis and phase analysis light scattering, with the latter being an upgraded method from the former. In these methods, an electric field is applied to a solution of molecules or a dispersion of particles, which then move with a velocity related to their Zeta potential. This velocity is measured using a laser interferometric technique evaluating the Doppler shift. This enables the calculation of electrophoretic mobility, and from this, Zeta potential and Zeta potential distribution. However, there are limitations to this approach. Due to the nature of the analysis, with it being an ensemble technique, individual particle sizes and Zeta potentials are not measured. Separating similarly sized populations based on Zeta potential is therefore not possible. Neither is the identification of a subtle shift in surface charge of a group of particles, which could be used as a diagnostic measurement. This limits the range of applications of which this technique may be used. As shown here, TRPS is a much more powerful technique for measuring the size and Zeta potential of individual particles. The major advantage of TRPS Zeta potential measurements is that they are single particle measurements which allow individual populations of charged particles to be identified. bulk sensing techniques such as phase analysis, light scattering, do not provide the depth of analysis into the sample that TRPS can. The TRPS method identifies the point at greatest resistance in the signal trace, the blockade peak, which in the preferred nanopore setup is close to the beginning of the blockade. For each blockade, the time at which the peak occurs is defined as T1 equals zero, the time at 100% of peak magnitude. And the maximum magnitude of the pulse relative to the local baseline resistance is recorded as delta R max. In the simplest case, the blockade is divided into N sections, and the duration from T1 is recorded for each section. In the example shown here, there are N equals 4 sections, 40%, 30%, 20%, and 10% of delta R max. The duration from T1 to each of these sections is identified as T0.4, T0.3, T0.2, and T0.1. By working with relative magnitudes for each blockade, the difference in particle size can be eliminated from the charge analysis calculations. When the proportional blockade magnitude is equal for any given particle, those particles are at the same position within the pore. The relative speed of those particles can therefore be directly derived by comparing the time it has taken for the particles to get to that point from T1. Regardless if particles are large or small, fast or slow, the relative magnitude is an indicator of the particle's position. Hence, the various Tx of calibration and sample can be directly related for zeta potential calculations. TRPS is a calibration-based method that measures the differential electrokinetic mobility of the agents while passing through a nanopore with respect to different applied voltages. Zeta potentials are then calculated from the measured mobilities based on this approximation. As a calibration technique, TRPS zeta potential measurements require the precise knowledge of the zeta potentials of a standard particle and the nanopore or membrane material. The method also considers particle transport due to convection, which is determined by evaluating particle speed versus applied pressure. TRPS can perform simultaneous size and zeta potential particle by particle measurements. If you have any questions or would like to know more, please contact us at support@izon.com. Thank you.